Careful!
I am being careful. Look how slow I'm going.
That looks so good. I said the blessing in the car, so I'm just gonna go ahead and dive in.
We are still waiting on the best part. Daphne's mac and cheese.
You think I don't know that? That's what my whole second plate is for.
I'd like to think you're joking, but I saw you eat it straight out of the crock pot last year.
Ain't no shame in my cheese game.
The wait is over.
The mac and cheese is here. Sorry I'm late. The traffic was awful. Did y'all know they made Gorgas Road into a one-way street? Because I didn't.
What is that?
It's mac and cheese.
Where's the crock pot?
Oh, I didn't need it. I baked it this time.
What's that brown stuff on top?
Panko breadcrumbs.
Oh, come on.
Why are you doing this to us?
I just wanted to try a new recipe.
The Southern People's Court is now in session.
Who are they?
Is that who Aunt Carol is dating now?
All three of them?
I don't know, maybe it's like a Mamma Mia situation.
Ma'am, you've been charged with the unlawful substitution of a potluck staple. How do you plead?
Are we seriously still talking about the mac and cheese?
Ignorance of the law is not a defense, Your Honor. The defendant was entrusted to bring a time-honored mac and cheese dish to this gathering. What did she bring instead? An experiment. Your Honor, this is a potluck, not a science fair.
It's not an experiment. It's one of the most popular recipes on Pinterest.
Our friendship is over. I'm willing to testify against her.
Unbelievable.
Your Honor, is a possum by any other name not feisty? My client volunteered out of the goodness of her own heart to bring the macaroni and cheese, and that is what she has done. The experimentation is inconsequential, and frankly, these proceedings are an insult to the very heart of Southern cooking.
Again, not an experiment. This recipe was on the Today Show. Hoda loved it.
I hope they hold you in contempt.
The question is not whether you can legally experiment in a Southern kitchen. Why, how else will we know about the miracle of a deep-fried honey bun? But there's a time and place for such things, and this is not it. The defendant deviated from the recipe her friends and family have come to love, thus depriving them of their specific cheese needs.
Ma'am, did you or did you not consult with your peers about the recipe change so that arrangements for a more familiar macaroni and cheese could be made?
I did not.
The prosecution rests, Your Honor. I make a motion for the death penalty.
Objection! Maybe 5 years of potluck probation.
I thought you were on my side.
Only God can help you now.
Okay, come on, this is ridiculous. It's a great recipe. At least try it first before you throw me in your pretend jail.
Wait, no, it's like real jail, right?
Here, just try it. If you don't like it, I can throw it all out.
Now wait a minute. Is that bacon?
Half a pound. Applewood smoked.
Deadgummit. I make a motion that we dismiss this case immediately, Your Honor. Adding meat to a side dish is one of the very pillars of this court. If there's a bacon bit, you must acquit.
She's right. That is the law.
I believe I've heard enough here. Ma'am, you have broken one of the most sacred laws of potluck procedures by substituting without consent. But your substitution was meat. And there is nothing this court loves more than adding fat and grease to a side dish. So I'm gonna let you off with a warning this time. But if you pull this stunt again, you're gonna be bringing plates to the next potluck.
Why plates?
Because that's what you tell someone to bring when you don't want to eat their food.
Is that why I always bring the ice? Hello?
What are you doing?
I'm trying to make us disappear.